In this tutorial, we'll cover many of the makeover features in Corel PaintShop Pro X5. These tools can help you touch up your images in a variety of ways. The blemish fixer, toothbrush, skin smoothing, scratch remover, retouch brushes, color changer, warp tools, and others are just a few of the tools that can be used to help people in your photos look their best. Let's get started. PaintShop Pro opens first into the Manage Workspace, one of several places where I can view images I want to work on. From here, let's move over to the Adjust workspace, where I can start making over my photos. Adjust provides the most common tools to edit and touch up your photos quickly and easily. While these tools are also available in the more advanced Edit workspace, I want to show you that the Adjust workspace provides a more focused, uncluttered environment in which to work, which can really help when you need to quickly edit multiple photos. Okay, I've been asked to make some cosmetic changes on several photos. The Makeover tool could quickly become one of your favorites in PaintShop Pro. It is incredibly easy to use, and the results are amazing. Selecting it displays a number of associated tools. Let's begin by using the tool on the far left, the Blemish Fixer. I'll start with this picture of Andre. Here are a couple of tips. You can zoom in and out using the mouse wheel. You can choose the Pan tool at any time by holding down the space bar. And letting go will return you to the previous tool. You can also resize many tools interactively by holding down the Alt key and dragging the mouse inward to make it smaller or outward to make it larger. The Blemish Fixer is similar to, but works smarter than your typical cloning tool. My cursor here shows two circles. The inside circle represents the area to be fixed, and the outer circle is the area it pulls the fix from. I'll place the inner circle over a blemish, click, and the blemish is instantly removed. I'll use this to remove the obvious blemishes in Andre's face, but leave her natural features. So, this is a good start. Let's use the toothbrush to whiten her teeth just a little. Simply set the strength and click her teeth. I'll click her back teeth as well. If the effect is overwhelming, you can undo it and adjust the strength again. Let me back up so you can see the difference between the before and after. If I'm done with my photo makeover, I can now save it and share it from here. But let's see what more we can do. Let's take our image over to the Edit workspace. The Edit workspace is used for more detailed image editing. Besides having more advanced tools to choose from, you also have the Layers palette. Layers are an excellent way to organize and separate processes in PaintShop Pro. The first thing I'll do is create a copy of the original image by duplicating the layer and naming it for the feature or features I'm going to apply. In this case, skin smoothing. I will now apply the skin smoothing effect on this single layer so I have the ability to hide it, delete it, compare it before and after, and adjust it. Go to Adjust Skin Smoothing. I'll set it to 50% and click OK. The results will be more noticeable if I zoom in. Notice that Andre's skin is smoother while her eyes and hair are left untouched. I can click the eye in the Layers palette to hide or show this effect. While we're zoomed in, you'll notice a stray hair or two. A great tool to remove these is the Scratch Remover. If I access this tool in the Learning Center, you'll read that this is a great tool for removing all kinds of lines, including wrinkles and telephone wires. The Learning Center will also select the tool in the toolbox for you. This time, instead of using the Alt key, I'll need to adjust the width of this tool using the slider in the Tool Options palette. The thinner, the better. I can even use it to minimize the scar on her forehead. Although we won't have time to cover them all here, another set of tools you should learn about are the retouch brushes. These brushes offer a set of very powerful and customizable tools that can be applied to specific areas instead of an entire layer or image. For example, you can use them to whiten eyes in a controlled fashion or to darken eyelashes. I'll show you a few of them. I'll duplicate the skin smoothing layer and name it Retouch Brushes. Then I'll use the Sharpen tool, with an opacity of around 50 to brush in more detail to her eyebrows and eyelashes. Because it's a brush, it only affects the areas that you touch. See how easy that was? It even increased the sparkle around her eyes. Next, I'll use the saturation up-down tool to reduce the rosiness in her cheeks just a little. In this case, I'll reduce the opacity to around 25 and then paint on her cheek areas. You'll want to left-click to increase saturation and right-click to decrease it. Much of what I'm doing is open to personal preference. How and where you use retouch brushes is completely up to you. If you want to adjust eye color, there are several ways to do it. One way is to use this rather amazing tool called the Change to Target tool that's in the same flyout as the retouch brushes. This tool allows me to paint by blending any color over another color. I'll adjust the opacity again, choose a nice blue color, and select the Hue mode. Again, I'll duplicate the previous layer and name it. Now I'll paint the eye. Look how natural that looks as it blends with the underlying layer instead of replacing it. There is another method to altering eye color that might work even better for you and allow more creativity. So let me undo the previous effect by just deleting the entire layer. This method involves creating a new layer instead of duplicating the previous one. This time, we're going to blend colors using a blend mode on the layer's palette. On my new layer, I'm going to use the Paint Brush tool, choose a color, and paint on the eyes again. Blend modes use different color and lighting techniques to blend the current layer with the layer underneath it. I find that the best one to use here is Hue. If it's too strong, try the less intense Hue Legacy. Because I created a layer that just contains the eye color, I can now change the eye color with the Color Changer tool without having to undo and redo paint strokes. Simply choose a new foreground color from the Materials palette and click a color on the layer that you want to change. Let's now compare the before and the after images. Okay, let's try a different type of makeover. Again, use the tools wisely. I'll choose Save As so we have a before and after copy of the image. There are two warping tools in the toolbar. The Mesh Warp tool is located here along with the Warp Brush tool. The Mesh Warp provides more structure by using a grid. Grid spacing can be adjusted on the Tool Options palette. A 4x4 setting works perfectly for this as it fits nicely with her waist. Watch me as I use it to trim her waistline and hips without altering other parts of the image. For additional adjustments, let's switch to the Warp Brush. There are several modes for this too. I'll set it to Contract mode to pull pixels inward and set a strength of 25 to 30 and a brush the size of her face or about 375. Simply click and drag downward to narrow her face and neck. I'll also slim her arm a little too. Alright, let's compare these before and after images. So there you have it. We've removed blemishes, whitened teeth, smoothed skin, removed unwanted hair, and emphasized features with retouch brushes. We've also looked at how to change eye color and how to slim and trim with warp tools. There are still many other ways to achieve great makeover results. If you need more information, check out the PaintShop Pro help files or explore the Corel guide for additional resources and tutorials.